The Wimpei Audiobook Series. Coiling Dragon, aka Panlong, by I Eat Tomatoes. Book 1, The Ring. Chapter 8, Magical Beast, Velocidragon. The giant creature that caused the earth to shake finally revealed itself. Upon seeing this enormous creature, Linli and the rest of the children were scared silly. Hillman. Roger and Lori's reaction speeds were very quick. They immediately stood in front of the group of kids and carefully watched the enormous creature. A magical beast of the 7th rank. Velocidragon asterisk. Hillman's facial expression contorted, while Lori and Roger, by his side, felt their legs grow weak. So bye, big. Is this a legendary magical beast? Linli was totally stunned. Since he was born, the largest creature which Linli had ever seen was the war horses that sometimes passed by Washington Township. Those large, powerful horses were 1.8 meters tall. But in front of this giant creature, they seemed like nothing more than a babe in front of a giant. The difference was truly astounding. This creature was easily 2 stories high and at least 20 or 30 meters long. Magical Beast, Velocidragon. The Velocidragon's entire body was covered by huge, fire-red scales, each scale glittering with a reflected cold, golden light. The scales alone were stunning and frightening to behold. The Velocidragon's 4-scale-covered long legs were even more terrifying in their thickness. 2 fully grown men would barely be able to surround them with their arms. The flame-red Velocidragon was entirely crimson in color, with the exception of its cold, deadly-looking black claws. The Velocidragon's long, scale-covered tail made up over half of its total body length. Like a whip, it swept across the ground. Each time it struck the ground, a deep thud could be heard emanating from below. Grr. With a low-throat growl, white steam erupted from the nostrils of the Velocidragon, carrying with it the stench of sulfur. Those diamond-like eyes, nearly the size of a lantern, were also, strangely enough, red as well. The huge head of the Velocidragon turned towards Linli and the children. Its cold gaze terrified all of the children, freezing them in their tracks. TCHHHTCHHH. The Velocidragon's mouth tensed, revealing 2 rows of enormous, saw-like teeth. Each tooth was ivory white, and the sight of them caused everyone's hearts to grow cold. No one dared to question its sharpness. Linli felt as though his heart had stopped beating. Right now, it seemed as though all sound had faded away. Too terrifying. Is there anyone who can possibly defeat such a creature? Linli was scared stiff. Just from looking at this huge magical beast, Linli felt as though its power was irresistible. Linli believed that with but a swipe of its enormous tail, most likely even the sturdiest stones of the houses of Washington Town would be disintegrated. Is this Washington Town? Suddenly, a cold voice emanated from on top of the Velocidragon. All of the terrified children looked up, astonished. Upon the Velocidragon's enormous, scaly back, a mysterious man wearing violet robes was sitting cross-legged. The Velocidragon was simply too huge in size, and its back was extremely broad. There was more than enough space for someone to stand, sit, or even roll around. Lord Magus, this is indeed Washington Town. Is there anything we can help you with, Lord Magus? Hillman's voice rang out. Upon hearing Hillman's voice, everyone seemed to find their bearings again. and recovered from the state of stunned terror. But everyone present, including Roger and Lori, didn't dare make a single sound. They all stood behind Hillman and fearfully looked at the terrifying Velocidragon and the mysterious, violet-robed Magus. Washington. Looks like I didn't get lost, the violet-robed man said in a low voice. And then the mysterious, violet-robed man didn't say anything else. After gazing at Linley and the rest of the group with its cold eyes, the Velocidragon continued forward, two more lines of smoke appearing from its nostrils. Seeing the Velocidragon go in the direction of the township, the expression on Hillman's face changed. Everyone, stay here. After he spoke, Hillman immediately chased after the departing Velocidragon. Uncle Lori, what is that? Is that a magical beast? Linley was the first to ask. Lori cleared his throat, a look of terror still in his eyes. But he still nodded. Yes, it is. But it's a very powerful one, a magical beast of the seventh rank. A Velocidragon. Velocidragon. Linley memorized the word, forever etching it in his mind. The Velocidragon's huge body, hard scales, sharp claws, and powerful tail served to create a terrifying appearance. Linley believed, a single Velocidragon could most likely annihilate the entire Washin Township. The defensive power of the Velocidragon's scales is astonishing, and its attack power is terrifying as well. In addition, it is proficient in destructive fire magic. Lori's heart was filled with fear as he explained to Linley and the others. If faced with a terrifying magical beast such as the Velocidragon, most likely even a platoon of 1,000 soldiers would be wiped out, unless it had a number of 6th or 7th ranked warriors and magi who could unite to penetrate the Velocidragon's scales. Linley's heart trembled. Even a platoon of 1,000 soldiers would be wiped out? However, the most terrifying thing is not the Velocidragon, it is the mysterious violet-robed man. Lori took two stabilizing breaths, calming his agitated heart. By his side, Roger nodded as well. Right. In order to subdue a Velocidragon, one must force the Velocidragon to willingly submit to being a servant. In other words, the violet-robed man must be significantly more powerful than the Velocidragon. Based on his clothing, he should be a Magus. At least a Magus of the 7th rank. Perhaps even a Magus of the 8th rank. Roger's fists couldn't help but tremble as well. I never imagined such an important individual would come to our home. Linley could also feel the fear which was in the hearts of Roger and Lori. Velocidragon, a magical beast of the 7th rank. And a mysterious Magus whose power dwarfed that of the Velocidragon? This definitely was enough to cause terror. The Magus was even more powerful than the Velocidragon. Linley found this somewhat hard to believe. The Velocidragon's huge body, hard scales, sharp claws, and powerful tail, all seemed to dwarf that small human figure of the Magus. Roar! Suddenly, an angry roar erupted from the middle of the township. Crap! Lori and Roger were stunned. Linley and the other children grew worried as well. Was the Velocidragon's angry roar caused by Uncle Hillman, or by Washin Township? Nobody knew. All of you, stay here. Lori and Roger, although terrified, still raced towards the center of the town. Linley gritted his teeth. Uncle Hillman. Linley was also worried for Uncle Hillman, as well as the citizens of Washington. He also ran in that direction. At this moment, Lori and Roger were both panic-stricken at the thought of the Velocidragon, and didn't notice Lindley following behind them. In but a few moments, they arrived in the middle of the town. Hillman was standing far away, watching. "Why did you come?" Hillman reprimanded in a severe tone. But upon seeing Lindley follow behind Lori and Roger, Hillman frowned even further. "Lindley, it's far too dangerous here. Go back immediately." Only now did Lori and Roger notice Lindley had followed them. "Lindley, why did you?" Lori and Roger didn't know what to say. "Uncle Hillman, I'm not going back." Lindley wasn't willing to return. Hillman helplessly shook his head. He knew how stubborn Lindley could be, and how hard it was to force him to change his mind. "Fine. Then stay behind me, do not go too far. As long as you stay next to me, I am confident that I can protect you." "Thank you, Uncle Hillman. I definitely won't run around." Lindley was overjoyed. At this point in time, Hillman's group was roughly 100 meters away from the Velocidragon. They quietly watched the events in the center of town unfold. In front of the huge Velocidragon, a group of youngsters could be seen. 4 men, 3 women. End of chapter 8. Continue to book 1, chapter 9. Thank you for listening the audiobook series by Winpei. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for the new updates of audiobooks and games reviews. Love and peace. Winpei.